What's an API? What's an SDK? And how are the two related? How can APIs and SDKs help streamline my cloud app development workflows? I'm Nathan Hekman from IBM Cloud, and before I jump in and answer that for you, please hit that subscribe button. All right, let's get started with an example. Let's say you're developing a mobile app for a veterinarian clinic, and the idea is for this mobile app to actually allow a receptionist to take a picture of a pet as it enters the clinic, and the app will communicate with a visual recognition service that's running on the cloud. And the idea is for the service to return maybe the pet's name and bring up their file. So how do we do this? How do we communicate between the mobile app and this cloud-based service? Well, that's where APIs and SDKs come in. Let's get started by talking about APIs. And we'll actually be comparing the two. So first of all, APIs are all about communication, right? So they're a set of definitions and protocols for apps or services to talk to other apps or services. So you can kind of think of them like a bridge between your app and, say, this cloud-based visual recognition service. So what does API stand for anyway? Well, it's application, programming, interface, API. And what are some of the aspects of APIs that make them useful? Well, like I said, they're all about communication. So communicating between a service and another service, an app and another app, it's how they talk to each other. Next, they're all about abstraction. What does abstraction mean? So inside the VR service up in the cloud, there's probably potentially thousands of lines of code running up there, right? And you, as a developer of a mobile app, you don't want to have to worry about, okay, which method in this service do I call to get, you know, the pet's name? You don't want to have to worry about that. So what an API does is it abstracts away all that complicated logic, so you just have to worry about getting just the data you need. It simplifies the process. And third, APIs are standardized, meaning there's industry-defined standards for how to define an API. And there's a few formats that are popular for APIs. You may have heard of SOAP, GraphQL, or REST, which, fun fact, stands for Representational State Transfer. And that's what we'll focus on for this video. So what are some of the building blocks of APIs? First of all, to actually send data or send what's called a request, from the mobile app to the VR service on the cloud, you need to have a few different pieces. So for a REST API call request, you need to have what's called an operation. So this could be HTTP methods like post, put, get, delete. In this case, it would be a post method, because you're sending a request over to the service, which might include something like maybe the file name of the image you took of the pet. Next would be parameters. This is optional, right? So this, in this case, might be the file name of the image you took. So maybe cat.jpg, if it's a cat that you took a picture of. And finally, would be the endpoint. So that's the URL, basically, of the visual recognition service that you're trying to talk to. So maybe that's, you know, it's some URL / analyze. Great. So that's your request, right? So this is what makes up a request. How about a response? What might a REST API response call that you receive back from the visual recognition service look like? Typically, it's some form of raw data, maybe JSON. So a request might look something like, or sorry, a response might look something like this, right? So you have sort of this data object that might include, you know, the result, the type, which is a cat, and maybe the name, which in this case, maybe Mittens just walked into the clinic. Great, so that's sort of the building blocks of what an API is, right? As a developer though, how do you actually call an API in your code, right? You don't want to have to worry about setting up your request with all these building blocks of operations parameters, endpoints, and dealing with raw JSON objects, right? So that's where SDKs come in and really shine. So let's talk about SDKs. What does that stand for? Well, it is Software Development Kit, SDK. Pretty straightforward, right? So SDKs you can really think of like a toolbox of tools or code that actually call APIs for you, right? Pretty cool, right? So you may be specialized in one programming language over the other. You know, there's SDKs in a variety of languages. So there's maybe an SDK in Java, in Node, maybe Go, or Python. Whichever language that is your specialty, there's probably an SDK for you. Perfect. So back to our example over here. What might an SDK look like in this example? So with an SDK, let's go ahead and put our little SDK toolbox within the mobile app. And for this case, since it's a mobile app, say we'll use the Java SDK. Great. So in this Java SDK, rather than having to configure your request manually with all these building blocks, you might actually call just a method that's maybe called, I don't know, get result, that will actually call these various building blocks, the operation, the parameters, and the request for you. It'll make it for you, and it'll make that API request for you with code. In response, you'll get a response, but it won't be necessarily a JSON object. It might be some code, you know, maybe a native model object in Java called an analyze response object. So the code might look something like this. So you have an analyze response object that you call the visual recognition analyze and get results method. You pass in a parameter which is cat.jpg, which is the name of the file that you sent over to the visual recognition service. And in response, you can actually go ahead and set a label in your mobile app to be Mittens, right? So that's the data you received in the form of an analyze response model object in Java via your SDK, and you're able to see Mittens has entered the building. So hopefully this kind of summarizes what's an API, what's an SDK, what are both used for, and how are they truly fundamental tools in your cloud app development toolbox. Thank you. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe. And don't forget, you can grow your skills and earn a badge with IBM Cloud Labs, which are free browser-based interactive Kubernetes labs.